Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'll show you guys some tricks and ways in which you can learn your device better. I'll be showing you guys ways to check your amount of RAM on the device, the storage, the processor is running, and even the resolution and refresh rate. All this is going to be helpful when you're going to buy a new product or you want to upgrade the existing one. Because the thing is, even if you want to upgrade the existing one, you should be able to know what everything is and what already you have installed on the device that needs changing. And when you're going to buy a new product, the salesperson always will try to bring something in front of you and they will praise the device as this is the only device you should purchase. But you should be able to verify everything that salesperson is telling you and check on the device that it has the same amount of RAM he's telling, the storage he's telling, or the processor he's telling that the computer has. So, if you liked the video and found it informative, drop a like on this video, comment down below what you like the most about the video, subscribe if you haven't already, and without further ado, let's get into the video. Alright, so we are on the computer screen now, and I will be showing you some clicks and ways you can get into the settings and see what the computer actually has. So first you have to open the laptop and come on this desktop. Then you have to locate this PC. As you find this PC, put your mouse over it and do a right click. Not a left click, but a right click. And you don't need to worry about any of these. Just go to the very bottom on the properties and do a left click on that. You will be presented with this screen in front of you. This screen has all the information you need to know what exactly is running on your device. So firstly, let's try to decode everything we see over here. In the Windows edition, we see that it is running Windows 10 Pro. And this is what you will see on your device. It might be Windows 10 or any other version of Windows that the computer is running at. And at the very bottom over here, you will be able to see that Windows is activated. This means that the Windows is licensed and it won't run out on you after a few months. All right. If you come to the system settings here, you will be able to see the processor the device is running. My device is running Intel Core i5-5300U processor. So we all know that Intel Core i5 is what the processor is, but this 5300 tells us the generation of the processor. The 5000 series means that it is running the 5th generation. If it was 6000 series, it was 6th generation. If it was 4000 series, it was 4th generation. So what number you see at the very first will tell you the generation of the processor. And then you will see the clock speeds over here, which doesn't need to bother you. Below it, you will see the installed RAM, which is 8GB on my device. And you will see some 7.8 or some lesser number in the bracket here, which means that a few amount of the RAM is being used currently by the system to run all of these programs. Then you will see the system type, which is 64-bit operating. This also doesn't need to bother you. And then you will see the pen and touch support. If your system supports touchscreen or pen input, then you will see here that pen and full Windows touch support with 10 touch points or any other type of configuration you will see here. So my device is a touchscreen and it does support pen as well. Below it, it is just the computer name, so you don't need to worry about that as well. So this is the top part is what we should be most concerned about and we should validate. The person will tell you the amount of RAM and you can check here the amount and that should match what he is saying and the processor that he is saying it runs, right? So next what I want to show you is another way to check the amount of storage and the amount of RAM in the processor. Now, these two settings should match with each other so that you can check that the computer is at the right position. What you will do is come to this black bar at the bottom of the screen and do a right click again. You will again see a list of settings. You don't need to worry about any of these. Just find Task Manager and do a left click on that. You will be presented with something like this. You don't need to go into details of all of these. Just directly go to the Performance tab and you will see all that is running on your device currently. So you will see the CPU here, which is the processor, and this also should match with what we already saw, which is Intel Core i5-5300U processor with with clock speed of 2.3 gigahertz. So this matches with what we just saw, and what I would like to do is keep this and that opened side by side so that we can validate while we are watching it. We can compare both of these. If we see any difference, we'll know that the device is not in the right state, it is faulty, and we should not purchase that device. So once the CPU has been checked that it matches what the salesperson is saying and these two settings shows the same thing, then we can move on to the memory part. Memory will show you the amount of RAM on your device. My device has 8 gigabytes of RAM DDR3. This shows you exactly that same. These two matches. Then we go to the disk, which is the storage. My device has 256 gigabytes of SSD on it, and you can check that here on the capacity section. You will not see the exact 256 or 500 GB number. You will see something which is closer to that, because as in the RAM also, some of the RAM is being used currently by the system. The storage is also currently being used, a bit of it, by the system. So that's why we do not see the entire number. We see almost near and closer. If you do not see a number which is closer, don't go for it. So now what we need to do, once we have checked both of these settings and validated that these both match to each other, we can close these both. Anywhere on the screen, just do a right click and you'll again see a number of settings. You don't need to worry about any of those for now. Just quickly go to display settings. Display settings is where you will find all the information about the screen resolution and everything. Once you're in this state, find advanced display setting, and when you go there, you will see the resolution of the screen. My device does not have the best resolution in the market, but it works for me because I do not do any color efficient work. And once that is done, you can either find it from this arrow, Intel HD graphics. If you do not find it from here, you can write it here on the search option, Intel HD graphics, and you will be presented with the settings. But this only will work if your system has Intel built in it. If it has AMD, you will see some other name here. So just go to this Intel HD graphics and go to display. Here you can see if your device has a refresh rate or not, and you can also check the resolution and compare with all what you saw earlier. And once you have checked everything, now you know and have validated and verified that what the salesperson was telling you, is it true or not? And now you know what decision you have to make to purchase a laptop or not, or do you want to upgrade it or not, right? So you can keep this video with you when you go to buy the new laptop, or you can try it right now. Just go back a few minutes and try this right now so you can get a hands-on experience, and I promise you will feel so much better about yourself, because you will feel like a computer geek while doing it, while going into the settings and actually knowing what you are doing. This is the purpose of the channel, to give you the skill set that makes you more comfortable around technology, and I hope it helps you all. So if you like the video, drop a like on it. Please comment down below what you like the most about the video and what you want to see in the future videos as well. A quick thing, this also was a suggestion from one of my subscribers, and I really appreciate that. Thank you for the suggestion. If you also have any other suggestions for me, let me know in the comments below. You can also DM me on my Instagram as well. I will be happy to make a video on that. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe to the channel so you do not miss out any other video from Upskill Yourself. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.